Naruto went through the Chunin exams, and Midoriya went through the sports festival. Naruto passed the first two phases, and then upset Kiba by a silly use of the fart no jutsu. Then, the huge upset of the show, up until this point, was him beating Neji. Midoriya passed the first two phases, and then upset Shinzo. He lost the next round to Todoroki, breaking all of his bones in the process. So what I want to talk about is how My Hero did the competition better than, for the main pack, a protagonist, than Naruto. Don't get me wrong. As a whole, the Chunin exams were better because there was more stake and we even saw people die. The Chunin exam turned girls and boys into men and women quick. I thought the sports festival was more entertaining, but then again, there really wasn't anything on the line. The sports festival just gets, your name out there, while the Chunin exams promotes you as a ninja and shows that your village is stronger than the others. What I really want to talk about is a comparison between both arcs of Naruto vs. Neji and Midoriya vs. Todoroki. Both kind of have the same theme going on. It was an OP person with unpopular thinking versus the underdog protagonist. Neji was seen as the stronger one the whole series up until this point. Once upon a time, the Byakugan was seen as a stronger eye than the Sharingan. You remember those days? I don't. Neji was making people shit their pants just by activating the Byakugan. Todoroki was the same way in terms of intimidation. Bakugo? He admitted that Todoroki was stronger and he was scared of him. Todoroki destroys the sports festival up until this fight with Midoriya. Now back to Naruto's story. Neji was mad at the system of the Hyuga and believed he was set on a certain destiny. He was mad, he was just a madman who had it out for the world. You saw this aggression when he beat the shit out of Hinata. He constantly tells Lee that he can't beat him and how Naruto can't become Hokage due to his destiny. Little did he know. The Sage of Nine Tails Naruto. Anyways, Naruto tries to use Talk no Jutsu, but he has to let his fighting do the talking. Naruto never lays a blow on him, and the Ninetales gives him the chakra to give one last push where they go for a head-on collision. Neji thinks that the fight is over, but little did he know that he was faking and gives him an uppercut. I don't think Naruto needed to win for this plot, character development, or story progression. The man even beat Gaara in the same day. He beat Neji and Gaara in the same day. Naruto was seen as a class clown who had no talent and immediately got seen as the strongest in a matter of minutes. Lee opened the fifth gate and lost to Gaara, and Sasuke used the damn Chidori and lost, and Naruto beat him right after beating Neji. I'm fine with Naruto beating Gaara, but why did he have to beat Neji? Naruto could have changed Neji's way of thinking without winning, and this is why I like Midoriya's way of getting things done. Midoriya was already looking sneaky strong by winning the race, then he used his brain to win the second round. This was him doing it without even using his quirk one for all. He then beat Shinzo, kinda how Naruto beat Neji, with, inside assistance. One for all helped Midoriya not cross the line, and the Ninetales gave Naruto the chakra to win. Midoriya made Todoroki use his fire quirk, and made him go all out. Todoroki won, but only due to Cementos getting in the way, in which he even made Todoroki shit his pants after seeing the results. Naruto could have done the same thing by having him stop the match just like this and make Neji win, but have him shit in the pants and ending, kind of showing that, how strong Naruto is. Neji could have then helped against the sand and show that he was opening up to Naruto's, in his ways of thinking, but not immediately. It would have been the same as Todoroki. Once he faced Bakugo, he had no clue what to think about his fire quirk. In the end, the plot, character, and story progression still could have happened without Naruto needing to beat Neji. My Hero was able to get it to work, and I think it would have been more effective than having Naruto beat Neji and Gaara in the same day and make Lee, Sasuke, and everyone else look weak. My Hero made everyone look strong, whereas Naruto made a lot of people look weak once he was done with the exams. So if you like this video, please subscribe for more Attack on Titan, One Punch Man, and My Hero content.